Welcome back. I decided to start recording in the middle of a loading screen because I'm freshly nourished. Just had dinner. Just wanted to talk a little bit before I started actually playing again. Oh, it just took a bump there. I'm thinking of going back to the 15-minute format. Across the last six episodes when I trashed all of them before restarting my recordings with a new game plus, I exceeded my 15-minute mark, and I doubled it for 30 minutes per episode, but I think I'm going to go back to the 15-minute thing just on for management's sake. I've always done that on purpose because 15-minute videos are easier to manage, they're quicker to upload, and I'm lagging a little bit, probably because of the fact that I am uploading to YouTube right now. I'm uploading episode 2 as I speak, but you may not see this video for another week. That rhymed. Oh, something's happening. Oh, I meet Drac.
Let's get to it before
this is actually the exact time I stopped recording on the original episode 6 or 7. Episode 7, I think. I met Drac, did a little bit more shooting around their Eos, and that was the end of it. Because the game was just too unstable. It was so jagged and laggy and slideshowy. Even this scene. But now it's a little bit more smooth. With lore settings.
That was pretty cool.
Well, yeah. Guess it was. Still haven't told me who you are.
Oh, come on, Drac. Stop that.
Ventra, what are you doing here?
I'm with the Pathfinder. That Pathfinder.
A friend of Ventra's a friend of mine.
You can call me Ryder.
I'm Drac, Clan Nakmore. You'll forgive me if I didn't just trust a stranger from the Nexus. They haven't exactly treated us well. What are you doing out here?
I carried him through most of my first playthrough.
Yeah, bet you're mowing.
He's supposed to be a tank, but he never tanks. Like, he uses his, like, Blood Rage ability in the middle of nowhere. And I've rarely ever seen him actually melee anybody. I have a couple times. But they don't really focus their fire on him like I wish they would. I built him for health and shields and regeneration and stuff like that. And he just. I still got hit a lot. Depending on how this playthrough goes through on normal mode, I do plan on doing Cora and PB, but I might replace Cora with him, depending on how it goes.
Yes, that is, Ventra. I'm a little too old to be carrying humans through a fight. Besides, the day I help the Nexus again is the day the clouds part and the Ket keel over. No offense.
I can do that first part.
Good, because I'm getting bored and the Ket are getting stronger. Seem particularly interested in this alien tech.
Remnant?
Yeah, that. I'm gonna go find more to shoot.
But he's pretty cool. I like Drac. I like most of the characters except for Liam and Cora. I find both of them kind of bland. Cora's just got a chip on her shoulder because she's mad at you for being Pathfinder and not her. And she's just a whiny little shit. And I'm just over it. Like, every other conversation with her is like, oh, I wish I was the Pathfinder. Why didn't your dad make me a Pathfinder? Shut up. It just kind of wore me down a little bit. It's like she comes around eventually because of course she does, but it was grating. And Liam, he's just your generic yes man. Like, everything's fine, everything's cool, let's all hug and be happy and I just find that archetype kind of boring. Sam didn't pipe up three times there. So that was nice of him to shut up.
I think that's enough.
I was also shit-talking this game a lot in the initial playthrough that I killed off. It's just I was suffering through the early game hell, which is actually a trope. Because
hey,
I like TV tropes.
Done. The monoliths are online and connected to...
Early game hell
something
can
in
encompass
lake.
A few different things,
this
but for me, it's
I
had no gear. I had to lower
don't
the difficulty even
me.
Because nothing ever died. I had no gear, no resources. I was dealing with the Viper 1 for the first three missions because I could not, for the life of me, gather enough resources to craft anything until like way into the thing. Most of my upgrades actually came from looting. And that was frustrating me because it wasn't giving me the stuff that I actually wanted. Like, I wanted the Black Widow, I wanted the Valkyrie. And I couldn't craft anything because just I was starved for resources. And I was actually doing the planet scanning thing. I was actually actively doing that. And I was kind of complaining a fair amount. I was complaining about this scanning, planet
this
scanning, because
be for
initially you couldn't skip the little
interface.
Random zooming in stuff, but they added that with the like facial patch that they did, so you can now skip those little cutscenes, and because they're really long and really dumb and really boring, but they removed that, so that's
dossier.
Nice. You just have to press tab and it just kind of skips it.
So, what's it say? That's classified.
Uh-huh.
Cora, why are you going to mention it if you're just going to say it's...
Okay, look. Not starting anything.
Ugh.
I'm military. You're not. But we're in this together now.
Oof.
Only thing that counts is getting out of it. If you've got the skills to help with that, and it looks like you do, then we're good. We're good.
I think there was another glitch they fixed.
Nice
there
work.
Was, like, no banter on Eos... originally, and I think they fixed that. So there's a lot, there's a few first
there.
Wave annoyances that
out
I did not
lake.
Have to suffer through
the
because I got this game like a
Let's
week
see.
Or two after it was released.
It's opening up. I see a door. Come on! Whoa. It's forming a bridge. Looks solid.
But
not,
I do have a few problems with this game on a narrative basis. I actually reviewed it when I had like 45 hours on the game. It should be on my Tumblr. I also have it on honestgamers.com. Just a few things I just do not care for. Narratively, I think it's kind of dumb that we're continuing to rely on some unknown alien technology. The Remnant is basically just Protheans. Like, it's the Protheans of this universe. It's like it's just a mystery for the sake of a mystery.
No.
Like we can't, like humans
no,
in the entire
right.
Mass Effect series can't do anything
for an
themselves.
There's some
and that's
kind of
grating to me.
There
and
must be.
I'm speaking as
do
a huge fan of the
Pathfinder
original trilogy.
Thing.
I think I explained during my Mass Effect 3 playthrough, which I think I have like 40 episodes uploaded right now. I explained that I didn't even subscribe
good.
To the whole the Mass Effect 3 endings were trash. Camp. I didn't
they make
care.
It look so easy.
They weren't that bad,
that's
and there was
a
also
long
a few
way down.
Nuances that people
can't
completely
tell how
missed.
Far.
But you can go watch that series if you want me to talk about that, which I do. Overall, the games are good. So is this one. It just, I think it has
it
some of the weakest writing of the series so
electrostatic?
Far.
Electrostatic, gravitation. Oh, you idiot, PB.
And I like the characters. I like the gameplay.
Door.
And I like the universe.
Is...
I'm gonna let her jump first this time.
What do you? Come on, Pathfinder! Hey!
It's a little laggy. But that's probably because I'm uploading to YouTube foolishly. I should not record while I'm doing that. But it's a 30-minute video. It's going to take like an hour. I will not be uploading this one. As soon as I'm done, I'm going to go back to my week. I don't know what slot I'm going to put Mass Effect in. I am doing double uploads on Tuesday and Thursday now, so I might throw my Andromeda games along with that side.
It's acting like a gravity well. But where's it taking us?
Embrace the unknown, Ryder.
I also don't like how I just don't like some of the designations. Because
like
apparently it's modeled after PB naming all
whatever
the remnant stuff. And it's
for
how a 10-year would name things.
Might be down here somewhere.
Like the observers are these little Oculus laser beam things, the nullifiers have shields, the breachers run at you and explode. It's like you look at them once and like, okay, I guess I'll call it the observer. Like, come on. But, you know, I kind of have to give it a little bit of a pass because there is the justification that
we
don't have a full grasp of the remnant language, at least not until, like, the very end of the game.
Controls. It's only minimal power. I don't think it
and as a result, we don't actually know what they're called anyway.
Processor, but...
Pathfinder, a conduit beneath the floor just activated. Fluid is running through it. It could be generating emergency power. Your scanner will have more details.
Not what we're looking for, but worth getting a record.
Watch your fingers. There might be traps.
I'm not detecting any.
I have made that mistake before.
Well, if the remnant aren't using it. I see the conduit, Sam. Whatever it is, it leads out of the
observing
room.
All this stuff gives me
got anything?
Remnant.
There's
research,
element zero threaded through all this.
Has a really cool set of armor, but it's not very good for me.
These data
in my general
are incredible.
Preferred in the playstyle that I prefer.
No signs of any cat. Maybe they can't get into the vault. But
is it gonna let me in?
That'll get their attention. Lucky me.
As I've mentioned before, I don't really recall what I have to do.
It's got power, right? Do we need a password?
Phrase recovered. Must read to access. This console links to surface facilities.
Here we go.
Then it must control
I'm waiting for
the
them
atmosphere
to
processor.
Be done talking.
No glyphs. It looks dead.
Come on.
Or locked down, like most of this place.
Am I missing
something?
Fluid
conduit leads to this console and further into the vault.
So if we follow that conduit, it might lead to the system lockdown.
What about these holographic patterns? Can you scan one?
Minor corruption detected.
There's nowhere to go.
The pattern suggests significant data presence.
Oh, jeez, so I just had to wait for them to shut up.
Another gravity well, and that's...
So much talking! I forgot what she does with that, if anything.
What is it? A symbol of authority? A key?
It's easy to speculate with Remnant, but we need more facts. I'll see what I can find on this beauty. Maybe over this way.
Whatever has this place on lockdown is that way.
I do my best work solo. You fix up the vault, I'll investigate the relic, and together we'll figure this place out.
Blue looks good on
you.
You
don't watch
blue
many
lighting.
More of this, do you? We have no idea what's down there.
And we never will if we miss something.
I was complaining about her lack of...
I'll be careful.
That, like, the texture is a little
radio.
Off. When
I'm
you
on
first
frequency
meter.
145.8. Stay safe.
It could be my computer
be
just not quite handling this thing
off,
in
right?
full.
This gravity well's sealed off. No way through.
Incidentally, a gravity well is the gravitational effect of a large mass in space. This.
Well, look at this. No way through.
Okay.
No interface points. Sam, note it down for later.
Comm check. It's. Well, you know who.
We read you, PB. Stay in touch. They dug this place through solid rock.
Look up there. Must be how they kept it from collapsing.
Looks like a blast shield. That might be handy. Whoa. What's that liquid?
Unable to classify.
The only way through is down towards it.
An unknown alloy and other materials. The composition resembles Omnigel.
Maybe that's the fluid in the conduit.
I keep thinking someone's watching us.
Remnant! I can do without. There was a certain point where I had this game almost completely stable. And I forgot what setting it was.
Careful, don't fall in that liquid. It burns through your shield.
It's fine right now.
Found that out the hard way. Use the pillars for cover.
But yeah, I'm a lot better at this game than I was when I first started. Obviously, after almost 60 hours, obviously. But it's probably going to be more interesting to watch me bounce and dodge around than what I was doing before, which was little to nothing. I wasn't exactly, like, I wasn't being stupid about standing in the open. I was using cover and stuff, but I wasn't... Like, I didn't discover this move, as I explained in earlier videos. I wasn't using this thing until, like, several videos in. In fact, I don't think I used it at all in my initial few videos. I might have discovered that when I stopped recording.
All this for an atmosphere.
And I don't even
processor.
Know how I discovered it. I think I was just testing buttons. And then I just did that. And I was like, oh, wait, sweet, that's cool. And then you can use it to traverse various... I need all y'all to get out of my way.
Another aqueduct. This liquid is everywhere.
If it really is like...
We've got company. More remnants.
They have a weak spot. I need to figure out what
it is. Watch the edges! Got it!
Oh, okay. It's right there in their face. Oh. Hard to hit when you're like
don't let them get above us.
Behind them. See, it's behind them. Oh.
Yay.
Alright. Bounce up, down. Let's go over here for loot. They said something about... They said, actually, there was, like dialogue with Sam about that door, but I guess I didn't trigger for whatever reason. Hi, Peeby.
Peeby!
There's one thing I miss. In Mass Effect 2 and 3, when you were a sniper, it gave you slow-mo, so you could line up shots a little easier. I miss that. That was so helpful.
Is that a good idea? Nothing venture, nothing gain.
I think there's loot over here.
It would take years to tunnel a place this big.
And good reasons to build it.
Yeah, bigger containers like that typically have better stuff in them. Like gear and such, and the smaller ones usually just have resources. Or just vendor trash. So when I see big containers, I'm like, yes, give me guns! Because they sell better.
That's one way to light a room. The atmosphere processor we found before didn't need all these steps. Dad just interfaced with it directly.
Let's not.
Direct intervention was necessary in that case, but clearly unwise.
Better safe than sorry! Take them out!
I wonder if no, right in their eyeball is a weak point. Consider a weak point. I'll run.
We're sure this well isn't going to open up under us. Pretty sure. Focus on the remnant.
Well sealed. Damn. Maybe we can use the conduit for emergency power.
Blind fire. Blind fire. Blind fire. Come on, this one, buddy. I don't like the charge that many. Oh, that's another thing that was giving me trouble in the early game hell. Is you don't start with any of the weapon weight bonuses, so everything's heavy. And it basically increased cooldowns for everything that you have. And it was just really frustrating to deal with. It just contributed to why I had to keep lowering the difficulty. I didn't go as low as narrative, but I went casual, and we're on normal right now.
Complete the circuit and allow the world to open.
What is they consider the baseline Mass Effect experience? Let's try.
Okay, let's hit both those consoles and complete the.
Power restored to the gravity well. The conduit leads down. Conduit fluid pressure is variable. There could be activity below.
Yeah.
Then let's dig deeper.
More stuff to murder. Oh, I went over the 15-minute thing after I explained that I was going to
Radiation
go back to the 15-minute thing, but I don't mind, because there's a lot to this game.
Around the time the Scourge appeared,
I'm probably going to eventually record all those really irritating...
Maybe the Scourge is why all this tech was abandoned?
Runarounds in the Nexus and even the Tempest. So I'm just going to go ahead and end this video and start it again immediately.
Crap.
Join me next week, or if you're a constant viewer, or a newcomer rather, you're probably going to see it in another video immediately. So either way, welcome.